द स्नेक ट्राइंग पोएम रिटन बाय WWE Ross फ्रॉम द बुक बीहाइव. दिस स्मॉल पोएम द स्नेक ट्राइंग सेज दैट ऑल द स्नेक्स आर नॉट पॉइजनस. Some of them are very, very harmless. It is foolish to kill a snake as soon as we see it. Even if a snake is poisonous, it will not do us harm. A snake always bites in self-protection. Otherwise, it is as harmless as any other creature. But sadly, human beings are so afraid of them and they always try to kill a snake as soon as they see it. This is what the message or the central idea of the poem is. WWE Ross gives a very, very beautiful that we human beings should not be afraid of the snakes. We should not kill them as soon as we see them. Now, in this poem, the snake trying, in the first stanza, the poet describes how the snake behaves when he's chased with a stick, how he moves. He moves in a very elegant way, in a very graceful manner. And then without harming anybody, it goes and he suddenly hides in the reeds. Reeds are long thin plants like bamboo, jise sarkanda kehte hain Hindi mein. To wo jaakar wahan par chup jata hai. And so now we come to the poem. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. The poet says that the snake trying to escape the pursuing stick. The snake is trying to escape. Escape means to get free from the pursuing stick. Pursuing means the following stick. Somebody means human being is running after him, following him, and he is running away to get free from that following with certain curvings of thin long body. And he moves with bends. Curvings means bends. Bends leke ghol ghol ghoom kar. He moves in curves. Curves mein वो अपनी लॉन्ग बॉडी के साथ जाता है. हाउ ब्यूटिफुल एंड ग्रेसफुल आर हिज शेप्स. बट द पोएट सेज दैट हिज मूवमेंट व्हेन ही मूव्स हिज बॉडी लुक्स वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल, वेरी वेरी ग्रेसफुल, वेरी वेरी अट्रैक्टिव. ही ग्लाइड्स थ्रू द वाटर अवे फ्रॉम द स्ट्रोक. एंड देन द स्नेक व्हेन ही सीज दैट समबडी इज आफ्टर हिम विद अ स्टिक, ही ग्लाइड्स मूव्स. ग्लाइड्स मीन्स ही मूव्स थ्रू द वाटर अवे फ्रॉम द स्ट्रोक. वो नहीं चाहता कि कोई कोई स्ट्रोक करे, स्ट्राइक करे, उसको हिट करे. वो जल्दी से भागकर छुप जाता है, पानी के अंदर चला जाता है. ओ लेट हिम गो ओवर द वॉटर इन टू द रीड्स टू हाइड विदाउट हर्ट. ओ लेट हिम गो ओवर द वॉटर इन टू द रीड्स टू हाइड विदाउट हर्ट. स्मॉल एंड ग्रीन ही इज हार्मलेस इवन टू चिल्ड्रन. द पोएट फॉर द सेज ओ लेट हिम गो, ही सेज ही रिक्वेस्ट द पीपल टू लेट हिम गो ओवर द वॉटर into the reeds to hide. He says let him go to the reeds. Reeds are, as I told you, they are long thin plants like bamboo. Wo kehta hai use jaane do reeds mein to hide without hurt. Use jaane do jahan par wo jana chahta hai without any hurt, jisse ki usko koi chot na lag sake, without being hit. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. Then the poet says that he is very small, he is very green. He is harmless even to children. वो कह रहा है ये वाला snake जो है ये poisonous नहीं है, because it is smaller and greener color. Such snakes are harmless for the children also. Then why are we killing him? Why are we after his life? Why do we want to kill him? Then the poet further says, along the sand he lay until observed and chased away. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green, slim reeds. The poet says, along the sand he lay until observed. Poet says that the him here means snake. So snake ko jo hai poet him kehke pukarta hai. Wo kehta hai, it will go into the reeds, wo reeds mein chala jayega. And then he will lie along the sand until observed. Wo sand mein pada rehta hai jab tak koi usko observe nahi karta, jab tak koi usko dekhta nahi hai. Then he says, and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples. And then he's chased away. Then he's followed by somebody with the stick, and now he vanishes in the ripples. Then he disappears. Vanishes means disappears. Then it disappears in the ripples, in the waves of the water, among the slim, green slim reeds, among the thin plants, green color plants, wo jaakar chup jata hai. So this is the central idea of the poem. This is the main message of the poem, that we should not kill a snake. And I agree very much with the poet that snake does not want to bite man unless it feels that man is going to kill it. But people are of different opinion. They think that all the snakes are poisonous, and it is in our nature to bite. In our nature, we are taught like this that all the snakes are poisonous and we should kill them. But aisa nahi hota. All the snakes are not at all poisonous. They are not venomous, and we should not kill all the snakes. They are also living beings. They also have a right to live on this earth. So this is the clear message of the poem, which we have studied. Very, very short poem, but a beautiful message it is given. Now see in this lines. Now let us see the rhyme scheme. See this line. Along the sand. Now see the last word is sand. So it will be A. He lay without observed. Sand and dirt, dirt sound is repeated. So both are A. And chased away, and now. Now is B. He vanishes in ripples. This is C. Among the green, slim reeds. It is D. So the rhyme scheme of the stanza is AA, BC, D. Okay. And please go through the poem and also the meaning of the poems. Thank you.